Face swaps are awful funny, weird, silly, even creepy, and they're all over the web. So that begs the question, how do face swaps work? Hi, I'm Alvin, a computer science PhD student and lecturer at UC Berkeley. In this video, I'll explain how a face swap works, starting with the basic version, then adding bells and whistles for more advanced versions. In the basic version, detect faces, drawing boxes around each face for your first step. Second, switch boxes, like this. However, notice the boxes don't match in size. To address that, resize both boxes to match the original. And there you have it, a basic face swap. To recap, we 1. Detect all faces, and swap pixels for those faces, then resize faces to fit. Next, we'll discuss 3 bells and whistles to upgrade our basic face swap to a meme-worthy, more professional-looking version. The first hack is to use keypoints instead of boxes. Keypoints correspond to meaningful parts of the face, like the nose bridge, area above the eyebrow, dimples, and more. So instead of boxing faces for step 1, we'll now detect keypoints on the face. For step 2, instead of switching boxes, we'll warp the face using its keypoints. To visualize a warp, take the keypoints from before. For a second face, we'll also extract keypoints. Take the 3 keypoints around their left eye. These keypoints form triangles. To face swap, we'll warp the triangle on the man to the triangle on the woman. Repeating for all triangles, we get this result, a slightly more realistic look. This warp automatically handles resizing, so we won't need to resize faces afterwards. To recap, detect keypoints first, then for every 3 points that make a triangle, warp it onto the corresponding triangle on the other face. After warping all keypoints, we have our face swap, which looks like this. You'll notice that there are still borders around the face, however. This means we need an extra step, motivating our next hack. Hack number 2 is to smooth colors along the edges. We'll explain a simple example first. This is a small 5-pixel image. The pasted face is in the right 3 pixels, and we thus see an edge denoted in red. To understand why we see an edge, look at the image's numeric representation and the differences between pixels. Subtract 1 from the first pixel to get the second. Subtract 6, subtract 1, then add 1. You'll notice the edge corresponds to a high difference, so to remove the edge, we reset that difference to 0, and recompute, keeping all the other differences the same. And ta-da! This removes our perceived edge. We call this technique gradient domain fusion. After applying gradient domain fusion to this image, we then get this. We're finally looking at a more realistic version. To recap, detect keypoints, warp keypoints, then smooth the edges. Now, one last problem. It's obvious the faces are pasted. On the right, the man's face is overexposed and more saturated than the rest of the image. On the left, the woman's face is clearly less saturated than the rest of the image. The colors are less vibrant. To fix this, we match the average color intensities. To see this visually, consider the original face and the new pasted face. The new face is obviously much darker and needs to be lightened. To compute how much to lighten by, consider the numeric representation of both images. Take their averages, and we get 8 for the original face and 2 for the new face. As a result, to match their averages, we adjust this image by multiplying all values by 4. This ensures our new, adjusted face has an average of 8, same as the original face. We do this calibration for all patches in the new face. This takes us from these faces to these. Notice that both faces are closer in saturation to the rest of their bodies than before. To recap, detect keypoints, warp keypoints, then recolor the new face by smoothing edges and matching color averages. And that's it. This 3-step algorithm produces the same face swaps you've seen all over the web. Here's before the swap, and here's after the swap. Let's see 2 more examples. Before the swap on the left, and after the swap on the right. And one last example. Before the face swap, focus on the eyeglasses. And after the face swap. And now you know how face swaps work. To learn more and build your own face swapper, see my computer vision course on Skillshare. Link is in the description. Thanks for watching.